Hello, I'm Mr. Tarrou. Today in my pre-calc class, I covered something called the definition of a difference quotient. Now, I'm early in the textbook, so it didn't really explain what this equation or expression did. It was really more about practicing your use of the function notation. But because this is pre-calculus, and I know it's coming up in the first chapter of calculus, which is derivatives and finding slopes of curved lines, I didn't go all that way with my introduction today, but I did want to make sure that those kids knew that this was a really, basically a very fancy form of slope. So I'd like to show you that today as well. We have a couple of points on a straight line, and of course, hopefully, we know that the slope formula is equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. You might know it as rise over run. Well, difference in y is a vertical movement. Difference in x is our horizontal movement. So, slope. Well, that's fine if you have two completely random points and we're not in function notation. So, let's remember that just for a second, if I write y equals 2x minus 1, in function notation, that's not this line by the way, in function notation that would be f of x equals 2x minus 1. You know, function notation is just a fancy way of writing the letter y. We do use it, though, in upper-level math in case we're using more than one equation. We want to name them so we know what we're working on. So the expression of f of x, it's not f times x, f of x is a replacement for y. Okay, so that being said, instead of labeling this as x1, y1, I'm going to take this and change it a little bit. I'm going to take out the y and replace it with f of x. Okay, sub 1. Whereas this one is going to be f of x sub 2. So now my formula, which is a basic slope formula you're used to, I'm going to rewrite that with function notation and have it look like this. Instead of y2, f of x sub 2 minus f of x sub 1 will replace y sub 1, just to emphasize again, function notation, f of is a replacement for y. Now we have this formula. Okay, well, this is a bunch of x's and y's, and you know, some of the function notation, but this definition has the variable of h in it. Let me show you where that came from. I'm going to take this original diagram, and what they do, and this is important for derivatives if you're just starting calculus, is they have one fixed point, and they measure the other point based on a horizontal direction. That horizontal direction is defined by the letter h, for let's just say horizontal. So now I have this fixed value of x, f of x. From there, I'm going to move to the right a fixed length of h. Well, if I define this as h, and we're going to go up to this point, I don't need this, I don't need this random x sub 2, like just some random x somewhere floating around. No. This x is going to be h units from this point, so I don't need another variable. I'm going to take this out, and we're going to rename this point yet again. It's going to be, if this is x sub 1, and I've moved over h units, now this point is x sub 1 plus h. Okay, well, what does that mean for the function notation? I had just a second ago f of x sub 2. Well, x sub 2 isn't here anymore. No, it's x sub 1 plus h. And honestly, if I'm only using one x, I don't need that subscript anymore, x plus h. So now the y value, if this is x plus h, this is the x. How do I find my y's? I plug them back in to the equation, which I'm pointing like there's one there, but there's not. Function notation will say that if you want your y value, f of whatever is fancy language for y, this y value is found by taking x plus h and plugging it, you know, into an equation if we had one. I skipped a numerical example because, you know, with YouTube I've only got 15 minutes. So now I have a new set of labels for my two points. Well, if using this labels, going back to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, generic formula for slope. Now I've got this fancy function version of slope, where y came out and f of x when in its place. Well, now with this new labeling with one point and a horizontal distance, I've got this. F of, let's say, f of 2, y sub 2, kind of like. So f of x plus h minus y sub 1. This is y2 minus y1 in the old form that you might be more familiar with. F of x. Oh, this is starting to look like this up here. Over x sub 2, which is x plus h, minus x sub 1, or x sub 2 minus x sub 1, x plus h, and x. If I clean this up, look, x minus x, those are going to cancel out, giving me what I started with. So if your book is defined, this definition of a difference quotient, it's not some like, whoa, it's going to come back in about chapter 11 maybe when you start doing your calculus introduction, and it is a basically a fancy version of slope. Let me make sure that you understand completely that this is slope. I'm going to do that by coming in here and saying, you know what I said a minute ago, that equation I wrote and I said wasn't going to represent this line, let's go ahead and do that. Let's say that this line is equal to y equals 2x minus 1. I said I wasn't going to use that, but let's go ahead. Because, you know, the y-intercept is below the x-axis. Let me get that just a second. And the slope, it's not drawn to scale, but let's say we are going up 2 and over 1 for slope. Now, that means that this line has a slope of 2. Lines do not have a slope that change. So if a line has a constant slope everywhere, when I use this example, probably should have f of x here, and apply it or use it with this definition that my pre-calc book gave, it should come out to be an answer of 2 if it truly does represent a fancy version of slope. Well, let's see. I'm going to highlight this in blue because the notation with this stuff can be really rather tough. F of, forget the rest of this, f of x plus h, that means take function f, wherever there's an x, plug in x plus h. So I really should have f of x there, but f of x equals 2x minus 1. So the function is 2 times something minus 1. I'm going to do this in blue to match that. 2 times something, 2x, minus 1. Where the x used to be, x plus h goes in its place. Okay, now there's a minus sign. It's white. I'm going to keep that white. F of x. Well, f of x plus h, that's just what I wrote, 2 times something minus 1 from down here. Now it's minus, I'm going to need a set of parentheses if I want to get my signs right, f of x. Again, my function, 2x minus 1. So 2x, now I'm not taking x out and replacing it with anything. There's no fanciness in here, just f of x minus 1 over h. So first part of the numerator is this blue. This is f of x plus h minus f of x. Go back and find the original function. Just copy it down over h. We're going to clean this up, and hopefully we get 2 as an answer. Otherwise, I've messed up. So multiply the 2 through. I'm going to distribute the negative through that's in front of this parentheses. We get 2x times, or excuse me, plus 2 times h. Minus 1, this negative will get multiplied through the parentheses with distributive like the 2. Negative 1 times 2. Negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. Over h. And let's see. 2x and negative 2x. Nice. Cancel out. 2h. Whoops. That doesn't cancel with anything. Let's get that back. But the negatives do. There's a negative 1 and a positive 1. And we're left with, just to make sure you see it, 2h, which I almost canceled out, over h. Well, what's 2h over h? 2. So I started with a function that I knew had a slope of 2. I applied it or passed it through the definition of difference quotient, which I said was a fancy way of saying slope or defining slope, and indeed, once everything cleared out, I got an answer of 2. Now, your pre-calc book will have a more complicated version of this where maybe it's a quadratic formula. If you have a curved line, its slope is constantly changing, so you'll have more than just a regular 2. It might be like 3x minus 4, but plus h. But I believe I'm close to running out of time, so thank you very much. Have a great day. Hey, I'm back. I just checked my time. I had some spare, about another 5 minutes. Let me see if I can finish another example for you on that difference of quotient definition. Let's take a look at this equation. And let's see if we can finish this in the allotted time and check out this slope. So we're going to run this function through this difference definition of difference quotient and see what happens. So we have, again, I'm going to highlight this in blue on the first part, f of x plus h. So I'm going to write this, and everywhere there's an x, I'm putting an x plus h. So something squared minus 4 times that same something plus 1. That's this part of the definition, minus the original function. So I'm again going to write in x squared minus 4x plus 1. All of that over h. Now I'm going to have to write quickly if I'm going to finish this example. So I'm going to be kind of quiet and just show you the steps to this. X plus h squared is going to be x squared plus 2xh plus h squared. Take the negative and distribute it. Negative 4x, another negative 4h plus 1. Take the negative that's in front of this parentheses. If you did not wrap that second half of the equation or the second half of that expression in parentheses, you will have sign errors that's going to cause you a problem. Negative x squared. Negative and a negative is positive 4x, and a negative is minus 1, all of that over h. Whoo, man, I got a lot of stuff going on here. If you're not really neat with your work, it is extremely easy to make a mistake that you do not, that you'll keep going and going and going and not catch with most algebra problems. So we have a positive x squared and a negative x squared. We have a positive h squared, and whoops, that was the only thing that was in there, so that's a little boo-boo. At any rate, we got positive, we have a negative 4x and a positive 4x. We have, what else? Let's see here. We got positive 1 and negative 1. 2xh, we've got a 4h, we've got an h squared, and we have an h in the bottom. Nothing else is going to cancel out. So let's see what happens here. I'm going to put the h squared first. Then we have 2xh, we've got 4, negative 4h, and that is all over h. Okay, so now what? Well, some stuff will cancel out. All three of these terms all have an h in them, so, and we have a denominator of h. This will clean up. This will cancel some. All of these have an h. How many can I take out? One of them. This has 2 to give up, but I can't take 2 out if these other only have 1 to give. So I'm going to show a set of parentheses, h, and factor that out, h squared. If I take 1 out, that leaves me with 1, 2xh. Again, I just took that one out that it had to give up. So I'm only left with 2x minus 4h. I've just pulled it out, leaving me with negative 4 all over h. Those h's cancel out, and what do we have? H plus 2x minus 4. If you're in a pre-calc book and they're beginning of the lesson or the year, this is it. That's your answer. If you're at the end of pre-calculus, you're going to find out what exactly that h does, where it goes, how this expression will be able to tell you the slope of a curved line anywhere. It's extremely cool. And if you're in calculus, well, this is old news. Thank you very much. Bam!